When somebody is codependent, they start to feel like they really can't live without this person. And so we've heard of people making a kind of a line in the sand and saying, either you do this or I'm going to leave. An ultimatum, do this or this is going to happen. But they're so codependent that they would never do that. From New Life Ministries, this is Going Deeper with Stephen Arterburn. I'm Stephen Arterburn. And Going Deeper is all about taking the tough issues, the hard issues of life, looking a little bit deeper inside so that we can gain some insight into our lives. Hi, Steve Arterburn here, and thanks for joining me with Going Deeper and Going Deeper into Codependency and People Pleasing. What does the CO stand for? Well, I've said it stands for you're cooperating with the dependency or the dependent. But I also think CO might stand for confusion, because it's very confusing when you're codependent. Because sometimes, you know, there are two different roles you could play. You could be a caregiver, but also a codependent caregiver. You know, if you have a child that has an addiction problem and they're 14 and living in your home, you're the caregiver. But you can also be the one that destroys that child because you're being codependent with them. You're enabling, or maybe even you're perpetrating the problem rather than doing something to make it better. How do we know if what we're doing is codependent or it's just taking care of business? It's caring for and providing what a person needs. Well, when somebody is codependent, they start to feel like they really can't live without this person. And so we've heard of people making a kind of a line in the sand and saying, either you do this or I'm going to leave. An ultimatum, do this or this is going to happen. But they're so codependent that they would never do that. One of my first experiences with this was in the little hospital that turned into an alcohol and drug treatment center in Fort Worth, Texas, when I was going to seminary. We converted the psych hospital into an alcohol and drug treatment center, and one of the patients that came in those early days was an alcoholic who had been drinking for 40 years. And in Texas, you didn't deal much at that time with prescription drug abuse or hard drug. It was mostly beer drinking guys that got in trouble. This woman had prayed, she had hoped, she had wished all her life that he would get well. He finally got sick enough that he had to be admitted to a treatment center. Couldn't function anymore. So he stayed with us. She went home and she died that night. I always thought, is it a coincidence or was mission accomplished? Her whole life had revolved around this guy. She would have never thought of leaving him. And so he was the center of attention for her life. That's one of those signs. Why do we have that? Why do we have that attention to someone else and not us? Maybe we are afraid of being abandoned. Maybe we were left at one point. Maybe someone betrayed us or abandoned us physically. And so we just simply cannot imagine leaving another person or saying something that would cause them to leave us, because we're so afraid of being abandoned. Now, there's another sign of codependency. To be codependent, you can't have anybody supporting you. Because if you have somebody that's really supporting you, they're going to say to you, hey, what are you doing? That's not good. That's not healthy. That's not helping anybody. So if you're out there on your own with no support system, that's a sign of being codependent. Especially when you've got that person causing problems, producing consequences that have to be dealt with on a regular basis. So without that support system that's saying, here, do this, do that, or this is what we see, then you're going to get in trouble and stay in trouble. The other thing is, there's kind of a sense of enmeshment with the other person. It's like we become them almost. And we see life through their eyes or feel it through their emotions. And we kind of lose ourself. And sometimes it's not kind of lose ourselves, we totally lose ourselves. And if you've lost yourself, you're probably not going to be secure in the things that you think and believe. And so there's a lot of self-doubt that's there, a lot of questioning what I do, insecurity. And so here's where the people-pleasing comes in. If I doubt myself and I'm a pleasing person and codependent, I'm going to do whatever I can to make you feel better. That's going to make me feel better. And pleasing doesn't please. It minimizes, it delays, it distracts. Nothing good in pleasing. And then finally, I would just say this, a codependent person is just full of resentment. Oh, you know, you don't say it out loud, that'd be tacky. But it's there. And you're kind of seething inside. You mumble to yourself. You've got this internal dialogue that's going all the time. And you resent the heck out of a lot of things. Probably the person you resent the most is yourself. How did I get myself into this? Well, I don't know how you got into it, but I know there's a way out. And so we're going to talk about how do we deal with or get out of or resolve some of these codependent relationships that we get in, and we'll do that next time here on Going Deeper. More insight on all of this you could get from the book, Take Your Life Back, and I hope you will. See you. Thank you for joining me for Going Deeper. I hope something I've said may have helped just a little bit. If you have a question you'd like me to answer or comment, just email me at stevesocial@newlife.com. I'll see you next time.
If you want to support Going Deeper with Stephen Arterburn, be sure to subscribe so you never miss another episode. And if you know someone who would benefit from this episode, be sure to share it with them. See you on the next Going Deeper with Stephen Arterburn from New Life Ministries.